You know how rich people say to spend other people's money? Let me give you an example of what that actually looks like. I grew up really poor and I was taught that talking about finances is trashy. It wasn't until I got around rich people that I realized they talk about money all the time, with their friends, with their kids, and they have plans to keep everything secure. One of my mentors has some special kind of life insurance policy that he can pull money out of whenever he wants. He bought it when he was 18, he paid $200 a month. Whenever he needs to make a big purchase, like a house or inventory or a car, he pulls money out of this account, makes his big purchase, puts it to work for him, it starts making money, and he pays himself back into that account. No interest, no banks involved. On top of that, he has two sons. When they were born, he bought them each one of these accounts. And when they turn 18, it's gonna be their graduation gifts. Now, they're starting life with access to this kind of capital. Meanwhile, in families like mine, we're teaching work hard, save hard, and maybe someday you'll be lucky enough to be able to afford a car in cash. Like, it's wild.
Yeah, okay. Well, it's funny that she's giving advice about whole life insurance, and at the top of the screen it says, not financial advice. Well, my not financial advice is stay away from whole life policies. One, they're one of the highest commission financial products that you can find out there. People who sell insurance products and financial products love it when people buy whole life policies because they make huge commissions. Anytime somebody's getting a huge commission, you have to think their advice may be a little skewed as to whether or not it's really a good idea for you. In fact, I would say if you compare all the different financial products, whole life policies are near the bottom of the list. There's much better ways to save and invest and grow your money. And I don't think it's trashy to talk about money at any level. It's trashy to talk about what you bought with your money or how much money you make compared to other people. But it's not trashy to talk about what are good ways to save and invest and grow your wealth and build wealth over time and set aside a cushion so you have money for emergencies and be able to afford things later in life and be able to retire comfortably. None of that's trashy, but it is kind of trashy to make a TikTok talking about a financial product with a big banner across the top that says not financial advice, where you're giving financial advice about a financial product that is a terrible decision, in my opinion, which I guess is financial advice. Although, you know, don't go out and not buy or buy a cash life policy based on this either, right? Talk to an actual qualified financial advisor and consider whether or not their advice is free, in which case it probably means they're earning money from commissions. Or if you're going to a fee-based advisor who's probably giving you the best advice because you're paying them regardless of what you buy from them. So there's my financial advice that's not financial advice. Don't listen to this. At least consider all the options and understand what you're getting into before taking advice directly from a TikTok.